Hello everybody and welcome back to WWE 2k16 Universe Mode here on Dynasty Gaming Brothers. This is Hell in a Cell Part 2. If you have not seen Part 1, you should go back and watch it. It was a phenomenal part, as we will kick off Part 2 with a United States Championship match, as our United States Champion Daniel Bryan making his way to the ring right now. Of course, as always, I am joined by my brother, JP.
Sup? Yes, Daniel Bryan has not quite established his absolute dominance, but he has been looking fantastic recently.
As, of course, he will have his opponent who he beat back at SummerSlam here tonight. And here he comes, the one and only Big Mac, on his way to the ring. Right now, looking for redemption. Of course, he lost to Daniel Bryan back at SummerSlam, and Daniel Bryan retained the United States Championship. But Big Mac earned his rematch, and he is looking for a big win here tonight to pick up that United States Championship. And Daniel Bryan looking to defend it in a big win for himself here tonight.
Big Mac looking pumped up. He really wants to win this match. Still attempting to prove himself. I mean, he's been around for a little while now, but still hasn't been around for as long as Bryan has. So if he beats a guy with this much experience, he will certainly be recognized as a contender for the big titles.
United States Championship is on the line. It is official. As Bryan getting his knee pads ready, and here we go. This match is underway as they tie up. Big Mac pushing Bryan back into the corner. Bryan, now the ref's going to separate him, and it is no one. No one's going to try and get a shot in. These two men, I guess, respect each other just a little bit. Of course, they have faced each other in their battles a couple of times in the past couple of weeks.
And Bryan now cranking the arm of Big Mac. Big Mac now standing back up. And Big Mac with a nice whip. And Bryan's over the ropes. And Mac just a punch right across the face. And Bryan is now outside of the ring.
Big Mac getting him back up. Now whipping him into the barricade. Bryan in trouble. And Bryan gets hit with a side suplex. And now referee counting still. Now Bryan with a jawbreaker. Nice counter from him. And now into the barricade again. Now what's Bryan doing? And oh, a nice move right there as the referee reaches a count of five. They better get back in the ring. And now, oh, a back body drop from Big Mac. Now rolling back into the ring. Big Mac needs to win the title by submission or pinfall in order to pick up the United States Championship. If he wins by countout, and the champion's advantage will come into play, and Bryan will retain. As now Bryan, bringing Big Mac for a ride, spinning the fireman's carry, and Bryan slams him down.
And now Bryan rolling him over, setting him up for a different move. Bryan, of course, is known for his very, very unique moves and reversals. Very athletic. He's very all around. So. You can never really tell exactly what he's going for next.
As, of course, he showed off one of those big reversals right there. Now Big Mac showing off one of his reversals with a punch to the midsection. And now slams him down with a body slam right there. Now rolling him over. Don't know what he has planned for. And now Bryan with the counter. Now exchanging punches, and Bryan with a counter of his own. Now look at Bryan. Oh, there it is. A nice suplex right there from Bryan. Now he's going to go for a cover. Daniel Bryan. Big Mac in trouble, count of two, but a kick out by Big Mac.
Now Bryan went for a move that required jumping, but Big Mac saw that and moved out of the way, which benefited Big Mac, for Bryan was on the ground, and Big Mac was able to hit another move, wearing Bryan down. He's trying to put him away here. Cover, wow, that got further than I thought it would, but not enough to put Daniel Bryan away. A lot of fire in that guy's heart. He definitely wants his title.
Now Big Mac with a couple of elbows to the shoulder of Bryan. Now, oh, just wrenching that arm right there as Big Mac going after that arm. Now getting Brian back up. Now whipping him into the corner. What's he has planned? What does he have planned for right here? Oh, Brian's in trouble. Look at Big Mac. He's from behind. What's he going for? Oh man, what a move from Big Mac. Now into a cover on Brian. This has to be it, too. Oh, a kick out by Daniel Bryan.
And now Brian, he's in trouble. Big Mac's got him locked in with a some sort of leg lock and punched away at Brian's head. Now Brian kicked to the back from Big Mac. Brian getting back up. Big Mac going to whip Brian into the corner. Brian facing the turnbuckle. Big Mac doesn't like that, turning him around. And now...
Uh-oh. Springboard Bulldog from Big Mac.
What a move from Big Mac. That might be enough to put Daniel Bryan away. Big Mac agrees with me. He thinks it's over. It's over here. But Bryan does not agree with that logic. He is already getting back up. Of course, a huge move like that would take down guys like even Big Show. But Daniel Bryan is a resilient fellow. And we see that here. Kicks to the stomach of Big Mac. And he's still just kicking away. And now he's setting up for huge spinning kick. And Big Mac is face down on the mat. Daniel Bryan rolls him over, going for a cover.
Here's a cover, count of two. No, Big Mac kicks out as these two men have hit some big moves, but not their biggest moves yet, but wearing each other down. And now Bryan with a couple of punches to the midsection, and now whipping him against the ropes. And look at Bryan. Oh, we caught him. Daniel Bryan caught him. Yes, lock. LaBelle locked in. He's put away so many superstars with this. And no, Big Mac reaches the ropes. And now a spear out of nowhere. Big Mac gets a spear. This has to be it. Two. And no, Bryan kicks out. Bryan kicks out of the spear. What a sequence of events. Bryan had the LaBelle locked in. And Big Mac got right back up, hit the spear, and Bryan kicked out. Now the two exchanging punches. Now Bryan with a counter and a punch to the midsection. The GOAT. No, counter from Big Mac. He wants this United States Championship really badly right now. Now getting Bryan back up. Now Bryan with an uppercut. Daniel Bryan. Bring him into the center of the ring. Now what's he going for? Bryan. Oh, man, what a counter from Big Mac. There's the athleticism right there. Now rolling him over. Big Mac with the knee and just driving it right into the mat. Big Mac. He might be kind of signaling for the end right here. And now, oh, a dropkick right to the head of Daniel Bryan. Now into a cover. Big Mac might have him here. Count of one, two, no! Bryan with another kick out. Of course, Big Mac with his good friend Maverick, who hasn't showed up in a while. And look at this counter. Look at the counter from Bryan. Beautiful counter right there. Now getting the crowd into it. And he might have taken a little too much time right there. Big Mac whipping Bryan into the corner. Uh-oh. He's got him up at the top again. At the top rope. Big Mac... As Bryan, he's in trouble and a side suplex off the top rope. This has to be it. Bryan is out. And Big Mac's not going for a cover. He's not going for a cover for some reason. And now he's getting him back up. Bryan in a belly-to-belly right there. Big Mac has Bryan down right where he wants him. I'm getting him back up. Now he's going to whip him into the corner.
See, Bryan has been attacking in short bursts, as we see here. He's been hitting big moves, but not commonly. Big Mac has been wearing him down more and hitting those big moves, that spear. But Daniel Bryan did get that a LaBelle lock. But so far, I think Big Mac has been in control for most of the match.
Uh-oh. Oh, man, Big Mac with a kick to the head and now a crossbody. Big crossbody from Big Mac. Now what's he going for? He's going to go over the top. Now he's going to try and dive at Brian. Almost hit the rolling senton right there, but Brian with a big counter. Now, Oh, he countered the kicks. Big Mac countered the kicks into a spear. Now what's he going for? Wait, he's not going to cover him. What is he doing? Big mistake. And now look at Big Mac. He wants to capitalize. And now, just sending Brian it face first into the mat. Now what's he going for? Big Mac, he's calling for it. He's calling for the spear again. And no, a spinning heel kick from Big Mac. That's another big move that he has. Two, and Brian kicks out. Daniel Bryan kicks out after the spinning heel kick. Big Mac, that's the first time he's used that move, but it was effective on Bryan, and now Bryan, look at him after the counter. He's got him up and taking Big Mac for a spin, and just sending him down.
Now Bryan, he may be setting up for something bigger here. Yes, he is. He's going to the top rope. Big Mac not making an attempt to roll away. Oh, yes he is! Yes he is! He was setting Daniel Bryan up the whole time, and his spear.
But Bryan got the ropes.
Daniel Bryan grabbed the ropes, but Big Mac hit a spear with Bryan jumping off the top rope. You don't see that often. Big Mac was patient enough to let Bryan set him up, and truly, Big Mac was the one setting Daniel Bryan up for that huge move, turning the tide of this match.
And now, a side suplex off the top from Big Mac, and what's he going for right here? Bryan is motionless right now. We gotta get a doctor out there, and an elbow drop to the back of Daniel Bryan. Big Mac has this match won right here. If he would just go for a cover, and he just drives the knee into the head of Daniel Bryan. I think the damage has been done. He's not going for a cover, though. A rookie mistake here from Big Mac. Now flipping him over and into a headlock. Just wearing Bryan down. Just wrenching at the neck of Daniel Bryan. Big Mac in full control right now. Of course, he has been for the whole match. Bryan has had just a couple of openings. Whereas he's almost capitalizing. Here's Bryan. Exchanging moves. And now Bryan with a counter. Look at Daniel Bryan. And this time, he'll connect with the kicks. Can he connect with the last one? The kicks to the midsection. And he got him. Bryan caught him. Daniel Bryan caught him. Now dragging Big Mac into the center of the ring. And he's not going to go for a cover. That might be a mistake from Bryan on his end. Of course, Big Mac did it earlier in the match. And it didn't work out for him. Bryan, he's calling for it. Knee plus from Daniel Bryan. Cover on Big Mac and that's it. Daniel Bryan retains the United States Championship, and he just sneaks away with it. Daniel Bryan barely hanging on to that championship here tonight, defeating Big Mac, but what a match it was. Daniel Bryan coming back after the very, very big mistake from Big Mac, and Daniel Bryan picks up a win here tonight.
Very impressive from Bryan. Like I said earlier in this match, he was going in short bursts, but still in the end, he nailed Big Mac with those huge kicks. Well done from Bryan. Retains his United States Championship. And now, for our next match, Sheamus is coming out, of course, as ready as always, strongman, definitely up for any challenge that faces him.
Of course, this will be for the Intercontinental Championship here tonight. Sheamus coming out, he is the Intercontinental Champion. as he will face off against Kevin Owens here tonight. Big match, as Kevin Owens dominated him just a couple of weeks ago on SmackDown.
Indeed he did, but Sheamus, still, he's still the champion, and he has in the past been very, very dominant. He's very intimidating, very strong, and surprisingly athletic, but Kevin Owens still is quite the opponent to face. I don't have much to say because it's pretty much a split even match.
Of course, Kevin Owens dominated Sheamus a couple of weeks ago on SmackDown as Big Show came out and assisted Sheamus in attacking Kevin Owens. But Kevin Owens is looking for redemption here tonight. We'll see if anyone comes out and helps Sheamus here tonight, as Kevin Owens making his way to the ring as he wants that Intercontinental Championship. He was so close a couple of weeks ago on SmackDown. We'll see if he can get it here tonight.
Yes, nonetheless, like you said, disqualification is not a way to win the title for Kevin Owens. So if someone comes out and assists Sheamus and the referee sees it and ends the match, Sheamus will retain the title despite Kevin Owens' obviously angry protests. But Kevin Owens, he's the rookie upstart, and Sheamus is the experienced warrior. So you can't really, I say it's split even. I don't know exactly who will win. I have no predictions. Of course, there's always the possibility of the Authority coming out and being a jerk, but I you never know.
As this, I never thought I'd be saying this, but Sheamus might be the underdog in this match. Kevin Owens dominated him. Kevin Owens dominated him a couple of weeks ago on SmackDown, as this match about to get underway, as here we go, this match is underway, and Sheamus right out of the gates, hitting a big move right there, as back to my statement, I believe that Sheamus is the underdog in this match.
And now, Sheamus... Kevin Owens, nice reversal uppercut. And now off that reversal, Kevin Owens, threw Sheamus into the corner. And now Sheamus laying face down on the mat. Kevin Owens, knee to the face. And Kevin getting Sheamus back up. He's going to whip him against the ropes. Very predictable. And an elbow to the head of Sheamus. Kevin Owens now just wearing Sheamus down before, near the end of the match where things get real. And now Sheamus, nice belly to belly.
Big belly to belly right there from Sheamus, as now getting him back up. Now Kevin Owens with a big counter. What a clothesline from Kevin Owens, sending Sheamus down. That was a massive clothesline. And now Kevin Owens going at the head of Sheamus. Sheamus in trouble right now. Kevin Owens just wearing him down. Now stomping away as Kevin Owens. No, Sheamus with a big counter. Just kicks the leg of Owens. Now Owens with the counter. These two going back and forth. And now Kevin Owens with a big bomb right there. A body slam from Kevin Owens. And now Sheamus with a counter back and forth. These two men seem unfazed by the other's move, as Sheamus drives a big elbow right into the midsection of Kevin Owens. Now getting him back up. And now Owens with a counter. Owens, now Sheamus with the counter. These two men are unfazed, and now Sheamus with a big clothesline. Now just stomping away at Owens, as it's only a matter of time before Owens with a counter, and here we go, Owens with a counter and a shoulder block right there.
And now Sheamus slowly getting back to his feet. Kevin Owens has Sheamus in a grappling maneuver. Now Kevin Owens just letting him go. Not sure how smart that is. You okay there? Good enough. And now Sheamus going to get back in control of the match. Kevin Owens turned around. Not a good position. Oh man, landing right on his neck. And that could not feel good from Kevin Owens' point of view. But Sheamus obviously going to use that momentum to maybe follow up. Yes, couple punches to the face and a nice uppercut and a spinning clothesline. Not exactly your discus clothesline you see from a lot of the other guys, but still, nice, dealing some damage. Now Fireman's Carry, Sheamus has got Kevin Owens up.
Uh-oh, white noise!
Jinx! And Sheamus is just hitting huge move after huge move. Cover from Sheamus. No, two count.
as these two men hitting massive moves on each other, and I have no idea how long this match will go on because these two men are two of the toughest men here in WWE, as Owens with a counter after the Sheamus counter, and now Owens whipping him over the ropes, and now this match will spill outside. This is scary. These two men, of course, very good outside of the ring, and now Owens grappling him in a sidewalk. No, a backbreaker. I thought he was going for a sidewalk slam right there, but Owens instead went for a backbreaker. Now Sheamus with a big counter and a big clothesline, now driving the knee into the head of Owens. Referee counting right now, and he punched to the midsection, or a kick to the midsection. Now a count of four. Owens rolls back into the ring. Now Sheamus follows. And now look at Owens. A big move from Kevin Owens, slamming Sheamus down into the mat. Kevin Owens getting him back up. The Celtic Warrior in trouble right now. Owens into the corner. Owens is going to turn him around. Owens with a kick to the midsection, and Sheamus falls. And now Owens, a cannonball! Cannonball from Kevin Owens! Big move right there! He might have Sheamus right here! Rolls him over! Sheamus is in trouble! Two! No! Sheamus kicks out, and another big move is kicked out of by these two men.
And now Kevin Owens is going after Sheamus with these punches, and now throwing Sheamus out of the ring. And now Kevin Owens bouncing against the ropes.
He's gonna fly.
Suicide dive from Kevin Owens. Huge move. Sheamus is sprawled outside of the ring, and Sheamus now with the assistance of Kevin Owens getting back up. And Sheamus, wow, a reversal, recovering pretty quickly from that suicide dive, but still Kevin Owens has certainly done the damage.
As big move from Owens, now an elbow drop by Sheamus, now getting him back up. Now Sheamus, Owens just getting right back up. Sheamus took a little too long to hit that move. Now Sheamus with an elbow to the head of Owens. Now Owens with a counter of his own. Owens. Now, he has Sheamus hooked up. And, oh man, what a move from Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens. Now he's going to bounce off the ropes. And, he hits it. He hits the big move right there, the big splash. Now he's not going to go for a cover, though. Now Owens with a punch to the back. Big punch to the back right there. Rolling him over. Owens. A stomp to the back of the leg of Sheamus. Now getting him back up. Owens. What's he going for right here? Owens! He's got him hooked and he punts him down into a cover. Two! And Sheamus kicks out again. Owens is pissed off. Sheamus kicks out again.
And now Kevin Owens. Huge move from Kevin. He's been hitting plenty of massive moves in his arsenal, but nonetheless, Sheamus tough enough to kick out. And now Sheamus setting up again. White noise! White noise from Sheamus. And now he's going to cover Kevin Owens. Two. I thought that was three. I legitly did. That's a little disappointing. But Kevin Owens kicks out yet again of Sheamus' signature.
Sheamus, he's got him up! He's got him up and sends him down! Celtic Cross from Sheamus! He has Owens beat right here! And now into a cover! Owens is in trouble! Two! No, he kicks out! Kevin Owens kicks out of the Celtic Cross and Sheamus can't believe it! Kevin Owens again! Kicking out, and Sheamus now sending him down to the floor, and Sheamus just wrenching at the neck of Kevin Owens. He cannot believe it. Sheamus has hit everything he has at Owens, but hasn't had any results.
And Kevin Owens has done the same. He's been hitting plenty of huge moves, but Sheamus has kicked out. Both of these guys are just amazing at kicking out of all kinds of massive finishers.
Two very tough guys.
And now, Sheamus is setting Kevin Owens in an uncomfortable situation, just digging his foot into the jaw of Kevin Owens. Owens now laying face down on the mat. Sheamus changing that, putting him face up. And now, Sheamus dragging him to the center of the ring. And a kick to the leg of Kevin Owens, more just wearing him down. But now Sheamus is going to the top rope. I'm not sure how smart this is.
We don't see this very often.
Indeed, and now an elbow drop. The risk pays off from Sheamus, but he's not going to go for a cover after that, and is instead going to continue wearing Kevin Owens down. Kevin will not stand for this. Gets back up.
Uh-oh.
Couple kicks.
Uh-oh. Pop up. Powerbomb to Sheamus. Cover by Owens. He has it won, and Kevin Owens is new Intercontinental Champion.
Huge win for Kevin Owens. He came out of nowhere with that pop-up powerbomb, and Sheamus just could not kick out of that despite everything else he has done tonight. He will be very disappointed, but of course the rematch clause will come into play. But for tonight, Kevin Owens is our new Intercontinental Champion. Yeah, grammar. But Kevin Owens must be very excited for his victory.
Here it was, that huge Celtic cross. This is when Sheamus just couldn't believe that Owens kicked out. I am surprised Owens had the endurance. He is the rightful champion since he kicked out of this. The Celtic cross has put so many superstars away. And here it was, the pop-up powerbomb. Kevin Owens finishing off Sheamus here tonight. And we have a new Intercontinental Champion.
Kevin Owens celebrating his victory, and the referee giving him his title. Kevin Owens does not believe in the referee handing him things. Instead, yanks it away. But that does not change the fact that Kevin Owens is our new champion. And, oh man, the lights have gone out. This could mean a lot of things. A lot of things indeed. Yes! But one specific thing it is, Chris Jericho, there he is, Y2J, his sparkly jacket looks as beautiful as ever, he's back, and Y2J is out here, not intending on celebrating Kevin Owens' victory, I don't believe so, Kevin Owens, shocked, Chris Jericho strolling into the ring casually, admiring these fans. Here he comes, coming down to the ring. Y2J. Oh!
Wait a minute!
Adrian Neville! That's Neville! Jericho comes out. Neville is entering. What is going on? Here comes Neville! There he is! And he is not being slow, coming down to the ring. Neville! Oh, man.
What side's he on, though? Is he on Owens' side, or is he on Jericho's side? As Brawl?
And, oh, we've got a two-on-two! Kevin Owens! A nice DDT, and now Neville going after Jericho! Jericho came out. He is, of course, the general manager, and he, of course, was looking to punish Kevin Owens, but Neville and Kevin Owens are not going to stand for that. Neville coming out here tonight.
And Kevin Owens and Neville are friends. I cannot believe it. Two of the most unlikely friends have just cleared the authority out.
And of course, they were faced each other in a match earlier this month, and they shook hands at the end. I guess they remembered that, Neville remembered that, and came out and saved the new Intercontinental Champions. A lot of different adjectives here, but Neville saving Kevin Owens. Maybe a new alliance formed against Chris Jericho. Wow, these two men standing tall in the end of this match.
Here we go. Wait, who is this? Could it be? Could it be? It's Jeff Hardy! Jeff Hardy's back! And is here at Hell in a Cell! Jeff Hardy is back! But what's he here for? Of course, he was attacked brutally at the SummerSlam pay-per-view by someone masked as, I don't know, are we going to find out who it is here tonight? We'll have to see if Jeff Hardy is going to call him out, or I don't know what he's going to do. Let's see what he has to say. Boy, it is good to be back here in the WWE here in Los Angeles. Well, I came out here tonight to call out one man and one man only. That is the man who attacked me. I'm just going to cut to the chase and call you out right now. And if you don't want to come out, you are the biggest coward I have ever seen. So come out here and face me face to face like a man. Get out here right now, whoever is under that mask. Well, what a call. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, could it be? It's Rob Van Dam. Rob Van Dam is here in Los Angeles. And is about to go face to face with Jeff Hardy. Rob Van Dam is coming out here tonight. He was the one all along who was attacked. Jeff Hardy. He's climbing into the ring. We have a Rob Van Dam versus Jeff Hardy face off. What a night! And Rob Van Dam and Jeff Hardy, here we go! Who's gonna strike first? These two men are ready! Oh, Hardy with a dropkick! Hardy hitting Rob Van Dam with a dropkick! And all these months that Rob Van Dam has given Hardy hell! All that aggression is coming out here tonight as there's a Hurricane Rana from Hardy! Stomping away at Van Dam. Van Dam rolling out of the way though. Van Dam. Oh, a hurricane rod of his own. Now Van Dam's turn. It's Van Dam's turn to go after Hardy. And another hurricane rana. Another hurricane rana and elbow drop from Van Dam. Now stomping away at Hardy. Rob Van Dam is out here tonight. Now Van Dam just going after Jeff. Now Jeff rolling out of the way. Jeff Hardy. Look at Hardy. Just wearing him down. And Hardy just releasing him out. And now a dropkick from Hardy. Dropkick from Hardy. Van Dam in trouble. Now we're going to go to the outside. These two men, very extreme superstars. Here we go. On the outside, Hardy and Van Dam. Now Hardy. Oh, what a move. What a move from Jeff Hardy. Hardy going after Van Dam. He's going to whip him right into the steel steps. And now look at Hardy. Look at Jeff Hardy. The announce table. The Spanish announce table. And now, oh man. Van Dam from behind. And what a move from Van Dam. That might have been a mistake from Hardy. Now he's rolling out of the way. Hardy. Oh, he's got him down. And the backwards powerbomb from Jeff Hardy. Van Dam in trouble. Now Hardy striking away. Hardy striking away. Now from behind, Hardy. Backwards twist of fate. Backwards twist of fate from Hardy. Van Dam in trouble. Hardy up against the announce table. Oh, don't do this, Jeff. Think about it. Think about it. Hardy's got him down. And sends Van Dam through the table. Rob Van Dam. Absolutely destroyed here tonight. And Jeff Hardy stands tall here tonight. What a spot. And what a way to end Hell in a Cell Part 2 what a night it has been, as Hell in a Cell Part 3 will be coming out. That will include our main events. And Jeff Hardy, standing tall, he is back! And so is Rob Van Dam. And these two men, I have a feeling this will not be the last time these two will be seeing each other. Hardy and Van Dam, what a spot! And Rob Van Dam is left in a heap. Thank you everybody so much for watching this video. If you liked it, be sure to hit that like button. And we'll see all you beautiful people, absolutely beautiful, in the next video. Have a great day. It's... Now Balor, he's got him out! Uh-oh, Balor! And a dropkick right into the corner! Dropkick into the corner by Balor! This is normally the setup. He's got him down, and a powerbomb from Balor! That's normally the setup for the coup de grace, but now he's just gonna go straight into a cover. Smart by Balor, 2-0!
Balor, he thought he had him there, oh, but that might cost him. While he's sitting crying in the-